Hello, I'm going to talk to you about a couple of things today, which is governance, risk, and compliance. The trinity of these three things actually decide whether your product or solution is going to take off in a certain market, in a certain region, or in a certain regulatory environment. So first of all, it's governance. So governance is ensuring that whether you have the effective processes in place to run your organization efficiently. Risk, in a short sentence, would be the positive or negative effect of something that would impact the way you do your business today. And compliance, of course, are you complying to various internal and external standards that you've set forth going ahead? So I was just talking and to a company that's into risk and governance compliance about on cloud security and so on. So while reviewing their product, they were complying themselves to various standards like ISO 27001, SOC level 1, level 2, then GDPR, for instance, and HIPAA as the other standard. Such companies actually are into helping other companies build the ecosystem around governance, risk, and compliance. So I remember way back in the day when I used to work for a large company, we were denied the opportunity to sell our product or bid for a tender in the UK because we were not compliant on DDA compliance. So DDA compliance was a disability initiative in the product, so which means that disabled people can use your product and they can get to speed with your product. So that's including inclusion, all kinds of inclusion in the product. So if your product is not DDA compliant, then you are not able to sell your product to that region. So we had to work for 6 to 8 months and then work it up. So governance is quite a part of the governance, and regulatory things are quite closely associated with the architecture review board. And if you see this structure that is there in the TOGAF body of knowledge, you see that architects interacting with governance bodies, with project management bodies, with service level agreement operations team, and that's it. There's a close-knit association with all of these teams, because failing which you will simply comply to their rules and regulations. So it's quite effective, imperative that the architect team or the product strategy team actually touch bases with the regulators, your compliance teams, and ensuring that you are compliant to various standards. And I remember back in the day, our head of engineering, when we were trying to deliver a product in the US region, so he did say that he had sleepless nights because they were okay with the rest of the world selling products in the rest of the world, but when it comes to mature markets like the European Union and the US region, you are expected to comply on certain norms and regulations, failing which the penalties are very high, and that could be a huge deterrent in your architecture and product roadmaps. So for instance, GDPR has become so much of a big thing, especially in the European Union these days, with 5% of penalty being imposed on the overall turnover of the company, and not only the profits, the turnover of the company. So that's how huge it is as a compliance standard that you need to do. So are you doing taking care of the governance and compliance risk checks as a leader, as a product designer, as a business designer in your products and solutions? So if not, it's time to do so. So it is all the household products that we use typically right from laptops to power banks to mobile chargers to geysers, electrical ovens, laptops, desktops, all of those in the Indian context are compliant to IS 35252 2010 standard. So similarly, our vehicles are compliant to Bharat emission standards, and if you fly a car in Europe, it's compliant to European emission standards. So this is quite important to get this compliance done. If you need to have a road map without any roadblocks, yeah, that you need to create architecturally. So here is leaving you with this short tip. So if you want to learn more on how to become a better solution architect, enterprise architect, or a product manager, or a business designer, so just log into eturnti.com/learning. Do share, like, and subscribe this video for more such tips and tricks. Thank you very much for watching.